guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and it's time for another movie review. This time I will be reviewing the movie Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, there is one thing in the trailers that got me very excited for the movie, and I just knew that I had to fucking see it. And that is a fucking raccoon kicking a lot of ass. Yeah, that truly is fucking awesome. So I saw the movie and boy, I wasn't disappointed. This movie truly is fucking awesome. So this movie basically tells the story of a group of people who are trying to protect a special orb. And a lot of people are after that particular orb. And even the people in that group fight for that orb. What's so special about it? Well, I'm not going to tell you that, but I will say that it's a very special orb. Now, the first character that I want to talk about is Rocket, played by Bradley Cooper. Now, Rocket is a raccoon, and he is the main reason why I wanted to see this movie. And I expected to see a raccoon who kicks a lot of ass. And not only did he kick a lot of ass, he is also the fucking best character of the entire movie. Everything about him is fucking awesome. He is incredibly smart, knows how to make good plans, is a skilled fighter. And best of all, every time I saw him on screen, I was like, hell yeah. The fact that this movie made a raccoon such a great character really is one hell of an accomplishment. Now the next character that I'm going to talk about is Peter Quill, played by Chris Pratt. Now, Peter is basically a guy from Earth who is a fucking idiot. But you know what? Despite how dumb he is also a character worth rooting for. Because he always tried to do the right thing, and he is also the main reason why the group stuck together. And I gotta admit, that's one hell of an accomplishment. He might be dumb, but damn it, he is an idiot worth rooting for. Now I'm going to talk about the villain of the movie, Ronan the Accuser, played by Lee Pace. Unfortunately, this movie does not have a great villain. Now, he does have the qualities of what makes a good villain. I mean, he is a major threat. But my problem with him is the fact that he is extremely forgettable. All he wants to do is destroy planets, which I have seen in so many fucking movies before this one. Now, a forgettable villain can be a major flaw of a movie, but to be honest, I don't think it's a major flaw of this one. In fact, the characters I'm supposed to root for are awesome enough to keep the movie fucking awesome. So I would say that the fact that the villain of the movie is forgettable is an extremely minor issue that I have with the movie. Because I can easily overlook that and just enjoy the rest of the movie. Now I'm going to talk about the humor. This movie is full of scenes that made me laugh because they were so fucking funny. But the great thing about this movie is the fact that it isn't a laugh-out comedy. This movie has a balance between serious moments and funny moments. Even though I was laughing a lot, I knew exactly what moments of the movie I was supposed to take seriously, and I did. Also, the fact that this movie can have fun with its own concept makes me have fun with it in return. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. This movie truly is fucking awesome. It has a lot of characters worth rooting for. It's incredibly funny, and the visuals are outstanding. So you know what? I'm going to give this movie the exact rating that it deserves, and that's 2 thumbs up. One more thing before I end this video. I would fucking love to see a sequel. Yeah, if a sequel will be made of this movie, I would gladly go to the theaters and fucking see it. And I can confirm there is indeed going to be a sequel, which is fucking awesome. Well guys, that's all I'm gonna say. Thank you for watching, have a great day.